Morning. You guys, I just want to give you an update on the seeds. I know I haven't done it much at all because I'm always a bit iffy and a bit scared because sometimes they just don't grow the way you want them to. But I have been fertilizing and watering, and I haven't really been thinning, so they may not be as bushy as they probably should be, but I just want to give you a look because I'm going to start hardening them off today, which means taking them outside for just a short time, getting them used to the outside and the air and the wind and, you know, whatever may come. And so I just wanted to let you know what we're looking at here, and I'm really excited by their growth. And I've got some strange ones. Look at that. Is this not grass? Like, look at this. This is ridiculous. This is supposed to be sunball crispedias. That looks like grass to me. Seriously, I have been afraid to pull it because I'm like, well, I've never grown sunball crispedias before. But I'm pretty sure that is not what that is. It's ridiculous. Anyway, so I've got my green globe artichokes looking really healthy, looking really nice, and they're gonna get so huge once I plant them in the garden. My basil has had kind of a rough time, but that will bounce back, and I'm really excited to get that going. So the sunball crispedias, the ones that I believe are actually the name, are doing okay. They've had kind of a rough start too, but you know, I never really blame the seeds. I blame myself because I'm not 100% great at growing plants from seeds. I do the best I can, but you know. And then look at my mahogany splendor. They're like mini trees. So they're really leggy, and that's probably because I haven't had the heart to thin them. And so they've, you know, they've done really, really well though. And I'll separate them out once I figure out where I'm gonna put them in the landscape. But they're doing really, really well. They're very strong. My lace flower blue, I only had two germinate, but they're looking really healthy, so I'm okay with that. My alyssum gold dust, just one, and it's not looking super great, so I'm not sure, you know, how well that's gonna do. My Queen Anne's lace green mist, now that's another one where I'm like, oops, that, it's like the Sesame Street song, which one doesn't belong? Yeah, so this guy, I think, I don't know if it's a gomphrena or what, but he certainly doesn't look like the others. The seeds are so tiny on most of these that you never know exactly where they're going, and that is obvious. So, and then the Dusty Miller, honestly, I don't think I got any germination from it because this one has a red stem that looks like the gomphrena purple. I'm thinking one kind of snuck along over into another cell. So, regardless, it's fine. Now, my Thunbergia, which is a vining plant, look! It is so amazing. Look how huge it is. And then we've got one that's a little slower, but I only had two pop up. But honestly, how many Thunbergias can you really handle? Oh, I have three. Okay, so I have another one. Anyway, because they're vining and they get super big, I was okay that I didn't need many more. The thing that you can do, which I didn't honestly have time to think about this year, was that the ones that you can see that did not germinate, you can actually go in with another seed and just keep filling the cells up. So some that maybe didn't germinate very well, I could try again, or try try different seeds. So we have plenty of time once I start the seeds for other things to grow. So I honestly didn't have time this year to worry about that, but next year, it's another year. All right, so if we move down, ooh, things are looking really green here. Hummingbird Salvia Coral Nymph is looking really good. It looks like I got 100% germination there, which is really great. So I'm excited for those, but I really did need to thin them because they're not quite as strong. Verbena Moss, and they're flowering. They've got little buds on them and stuff. However, I've got some sneaky ones in here that don't look like the others. That's just me with seeds. I don't understand it. All right, so this one, Snapdragon Potomac Mix. Oh, look at this one. Look how beautiful. It's got, if I put it here under the light, you can see it better. It's got some pink on it. So I've got some tall ones, some shorter ones. Again, I didn't thin. I know, it's very naughty. And then if we look behind here, I've got Gomphrena Audrey Mix. So this is gonna be a mix of colors, and I got 100% germination on these guys. They're so tough. I love Gomphrena. I will forever get these from seed or plants. They are just the most fun. Gomphrena Pink, looks like 100% germination there. And Snapdragon Night and Day. Oh, they're looking great. Nice and tall and healthy. Now we're coming to the graveyard ones that I did with you in a video, the peppers and tomatoes. Now, this one is in a self-watering base. This one is not, because I kept forgetting. So my poor little red bell peppers didn't make it. I have one Fire Away Hot and Heavy that's looking good, which is fine, because I, to be honest, I only really wanted one. Salsa Pepper Blend, I'm really sad about that one. Tomatillos, I knew didn't make it, and so I actually bought a plant at my local garden center. But I do have two cherry tomatoes that I can separate, and those are looking really good. Big Boy, not so much. These guys that look like grass, well, that's because it is. This is the bunny grass that I seeded because I didn't have any more tomatoes and peppers to finish out the tray. So they're looking good. I've never grown them before, and I have a sneaky something or other in here. We'll find out. Now the Brandywine tomatoes. Got two there, so I can definitely get those two separated. Romas, nope. Garden Treasures, nope. Rutgers tomatoes, nope. And the Nocturne peppers, those were, they had the black foliage, and they looked really cool. And I had one that germinated, but then I managed to kill it. Ugh. Down at the next set of plants, we've got Pincushion Summer Sangria, 100% germination. They're looking great. Amaranth Burgundy, looking really good, with a couple interlopers here. This one is not a Burgundy Amaranth, and neither is this one. So Another thing to look for and see what exactly it is. Pincushion Black Knight. I got 90% germination. So, but what is here is looking really, really good. And then in the back is the Queen Anne's Lace, Queen of Africa. And they're doing good. I must have missed watering a little bit because a couple of them are a little crispy. 90% germination on that one as well. So I think we're looking really good. So now it's just time to take them out into the backyard onto the deck and just let them harden over. I did have a fan on them and then the fan broke and then I didn't get another fan. The fan just basically blows them around to strengthen their stems so that they can withstand the outside once they get planted out there, and they'll do much better. But that was my fault. I didn't end up getting another fan. So yeah, lots of lessons here. Lots of lessons for me to learn. I haven't had the fungus gnats this year, which is great. Last year I did, and it was horrible. I do have the fungus gnat catchers. They're yellow and very sticky on both sides. I didn't need them this year, which was great. I did see, I think, two when I was giving you this little tour, but that's nothing like I had last year, and I'm so grateful. So that is our little tour of my seeds that I showed you when we planted them. I'll be giving you a tour later on once, you know, and I'll show you once I get them planted and where they're going once I figure that out myself. And I just wanted to show you how they're doing, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.